congratulations on a great tournament. Just talk a little bit about it, meddling, coming out of here and doing that. It's kind of what's going through your head.
That's good. I mean, I knew that if I had full strength, the semis, I don't know, my match, and I'll make it.
Now, your arm's a little hurt. Is that something serious, or it's just kind of...
Yeah, they said that. Change that to tomorrow.
Let me ask you, because I've always wanted to know, is it worth it winning the medal if you hurt yourself?
It's worth it, because all my hard work paid off on the podium, but I was expecting to be a little higher.
Would you rather it be first if you were?
Definitely, no doubt.
And what do you do to, you know, I know you're going to have a little rehab, you know, I don't know how I'm going to put you out. What do you do to get ready, you know, how long do you take off after you're clear to wrestle, or are you just going right back into it?
I'm probably taking my conditioning up, start running again, I'm trying to go out in the morning. And I start going with swim technique and probably getting a little bit of style.
And finally, Pope John had a really successful year this year. Just talk about that, guys. You got your finalists, a couple of the medalists, and Coach Piotrowski's kind of what you've done and what they've done to help rebuild that program.
Well, they've been at our practices and push us out every day at practice. And I think it's great that most of the cool kids on our team now all plays. Some of us got hurt, some of us placed.
A good showing.
Yeah, good showing.
Perfect. Congratulations. Congratulations on meddling down here. Just talk a little bit about it. I know we had talked all year. You wanted to get higher up on the podium, but you finished. Just how you're feeling now.
I'm not satisfied, obviously. I came into this tournament wanting to make it to the finals. That's always been a big goal of mine since freshman year. But I had a tough loss in the quarters. I battled back in the blood round, and I'm kind of proud of myself. You know, I took seventh. I medaled my third medal. You know, I ended the season with the winningest record, 143 wins from Westmore Central. So, you know, it's a good career. And, I'm going on to Rutgers next year, and I've got a lot of big things ahead of me, and I still believe that my best wrestling is ahead of me. So, little unhappy, but it's going to drive me to do better.
Now reflect on that a little bit with the 143, with Wes Morris, just, you know, your high school career wrapping up for the most part. Just how you feel. I mean, obviously you wanted to win, but you come down and you said you medal three times. Just how you feel, looking back, obviously, and, you know, how you look back on your career going forward.
Yeah, so when I was in eighth grade, I made the decision to go to Wes Morris. I wanted to compete for my hometown school. I had the opportunity to go to Blair, DeHoren, you know, but I decided that it'd be a great thing if, you know, Wes Morris had a great youth wrestler coming up to the program, coming to their school, you know. I knew ahead of time that I was going to be a great wrestler in high school, and I just really, it feels good to do it in front of my hometown, my family, my friends. And, you know, once I get into that Rutgers room and I have all the best guys around me, Coach Rossi, Coach Merrill, Valella, they're all great coaches. But as soon as I have guys beating on me, like, you know, Patesel and Ashnall, that's when I jump levels, you know. So it's been a good career, and I'm proud of myself, and I'm thankful for my coaches and everybody around me.
We'll talk about those coaches, because Rossi, you know, has been down here, he kind of knew the path, and, you know, it's a special kinship with these coaches, especially when you're down here and they've come down here. Just what they've meant to you, not only as a wrestler, but I mean, you've been in the room for 4 years, just growing up with him, being around you for four years.
Yeah, I mean, all the coaches are like second fathers to me. They're not just coaches, but they're mentors, and they're leaders for me. You know, I've learned life lessons from them, not just how to wrestle, but how to be a great person with great character, and how to treat your parents when you're cutting weight, and, you know, just getting up for dual meets. Coach Rossi would make us wear a shirt and ties at every dual meet when other teams were walking in with sweats and their slippers. You know, they taught us responsibility, and I'm really happy that I went to Wes Morris, because I don't think in any other place I would have the opportunity to have such great coaches like that.
Well, congratulations on a great career, and I'm sure at Rutgers we won't find here, and Mets were winning big in the tournament, so congratulations on the tournament and coming down here and playing. Just kind of what you were going through, your thoughts, and just, you know, how it feels to be a medalist.
You know, it feels pretty great. You know, I'm head on straight the whole time, and I was focused at my goals. Obviously, you know, first would have been the goal, but I had a great tournament. I feel I believe myself, my coaches, so I'm pretty happy.
What do I've never made it down here. I was never that good. That heavyweight, I was decent. That was a great. When you get down here, and your ultimate goal is to get that first, and you fall in a quarterback or a semifinal, how do you kind of get over that and go, because everybody's so goal-oriented and getting that first? How do you recover from that?
For me, it's just you want to stay out of the arena. You want to keep focused, you know, replay all the good things that you've done throughout the tournament, not dwell on the bad things, and surround yourself with positive people and positive thoughts, and just, you know, stay, remain, you know, change your goal. If your goal is big first, then you don't get that, you gotta adapt and come back to big third. So,
you guys are a young squad. Coach Piotrowski's got the team on the upswing. Just kind of what you guys look for building off of this. You medaled, you had a couple other medals, you have somebody in the finals, just kind of, you know, what you guys build off towards next year.
We're looking to keep growing, and we're, you know, grinding, you know, every day in practice, you know, every day, and it's paying off, you know. Three guys in the quarters, three guys in the semis, it's awesome.
Congratulations, you know, great tournament down here. Just talk a little bit about your season, just how you feel, knowing how you performed down here.
How I performed with that torn meniscus. It was really hard to come back after hurting myself, like, before the first tournament, and I battled through that in counties, districts, and regions, and then came here and got on the medal stand.
Talk about, how does that feel? I mean, you know, sometimes with the meniscus, some people think their season's over. You know, how was that going through your head? Did you know you can come back at some point? And then, not only that, get so started so late and be into that, you know, shape to come down here and medal.
Yeah, well, I'm always really in shape because I work at that Pinnacle and we do, like, upper body stuff, so we...
Mike Kennedy,
yeah. And I thought I was going to be done for the season when I got hurt, but then my doctor said, you're going to have to get surgery, but I didn't want to get surgery, so I wouldn't be out the season, so I wanted to just wrestle with the torn meniscus, and then I'm getting surgery in, like, a week or two. And then I just felt like going to Mike Kennedy's and then going to Edge Wrestling, I felt like I was already in shape and I can go out there even with one leg and still be pretty dominant.
Now you come down here, like, did it change a little bit with districts and regions being switched around? Because before it would have been easy because you knew you kind of knew Hanover Park here, this and that, but now you're in a different district and region. Did that change your approach any, you know, for any pressure, or was it just kind of go out there and do what you need to do?
Nah, I just had to wrestle my style and just don't let him wrestle his style. Let me wrestle his style, and then that's what I did most of that tournament.
Another senior came down here, Mike Gillick. Talk about you guys, you know, you guys and your friends, you know, getting down here, him just missing out on meddling. What it means for Precipity, you know, had it down here, doing wide, but winds up, you know, get two guys down here in the States, just what it means for this one.
It means a lot because me and Mike have been wrestling since we were, like, in, like, first grade, and it's just really exciting for Mike to make it down his senior year and go round of 12, which is really far. Like, I didn't go round of 12 my first year. I won one and then lost both of them. But it's really exciting. Then we have our upcoming guys like Sean Gentile. He's going to be Jared Bass.
Very good, Sean. Very good.
They're under the radar, but they're going to be good.
Those kids are going to sneak up on you. Like, oh, wow, they were there for that.
Jared and Sean, they're going to sneak up on you and get to States.
Well, congratulations on a great career.
Thank
I saw Mr. Illich post the pictures of you and Mike going back. Mike never smiles, does he? Never. You got to get him in a really weird moment to get it, but
yeah,
congratulations. Congratulations. You got, you know, great performance out here. And you want to talk about under the radar, sneaking in, winning the counties, and going from there. Mr. Massetti called it text message. But congratulations. Good luck. Congratulations. Just talk a little bit about, you know, your tournament, just coming down here and walking away with the medal.
I was going into it, I was pretty confident. I knew I could hang with most of these guys. And that first match, I just knew I had to stick my plan and just stay in a position. And then I turned out and ended up winning that one. Second match, didn't go too hot, but I mean, it just kind of bounced back from that. Then I just kept on trying to be aggressive, and just, like, I eventually just, it didn't happen. I don't know. It's just
now, it's like a high pressure tournament that you're at down here. How do you bounce back from that? Because, I mean, I always feel it's strange, like, it's hard, especially if you're in the quarters or semi, and you wind up losing, you have to come back and wrestle within another hour. How do you put that behind you? The goal, obviously, is number one. How do you, as a wrestler, do that?
Personally, I like talking to my coach about it, like what I did wrong and what I have to do for my next match, and just try to like push behind me and focus on that one and just change what I did last time.
Now, are you satisfied with how you're
I'm pretty satisfied. I know I could have gotten
better. Congratulations on a successful tournament in a year. Just talk about how it feels now to be a medalist at States.
Well, I mean, I came really close last year, lost in round 12, and that was heartbreaking. I think that really set up my motivation for the entire year. I mean, for the summer, for the spring, and the whole off season for me to work a lot harder. I mean, it meant a lot for me to be able to place. I obviously didn't reach my goal. I wanted to be state champ this year, but I'm happy with the outcome because I believe I wrestled in the hardest weight class in the state.
now one of your teammates has a shot at the state title. Talk about it, because you guys kind of help, you know, run the room. You guys, just how it feels, especially with you guys having a group title and that this year, just this season for Del Valle.
I mean, it's crazy. Del Valle hasn't had a state champ in 10 years. Last person was Danny Kelly. Not having a champ in that long and an opportunity just a couple hours away for Leitner to get that is incredible. I mean, we came off a Group 2 state champ. Our team rung the bell, our individuals rung the bell, everybody wrestled well this year, and it's because of our team.
Talk a little bit about your coach. I know he's very animated, keeps it light. It's one of the few coaches who has had success, and I've been to some of your early practices. You guys kind of loosen up a different way, and it's more of a team building. How do you think that relates? Because, I mean, you guys seem like almost like a family.
We are, definitely, we are. Every kid on the team, if you look up in the stands, not right now, but like a couple hours ago when I was wrestling, every single kid on the team is up there. They're all watching us. All the 50 kids that we have on our team this year were there. They watch us. We all support each other. And, I mean, I would not have been able to make it where I did, and Kyle wouldn't be able to make it where he is right now if it wasn't for every kid making us better every day.
And finally, looking back on it now, I know you just finished wrestling about 45 minutes ago. Yeah. How, dude, does it you feel about your career? Is it, like, looking at it, are you satisfied with you looking back? Are you going to have regrets in 20 years, or are you happy with how you feel your career is going with Del Valle?
I mean, obviously, I'm upset that I didn't get what I wanted. I didn't get that state title that I was looking for the past 4 years. But looking back at my career, I know that I worked hard. I know that I made a great family and had great coaches along the side, and I really had the time of my life. Del Valle Wrestling meant the world to me, and it always will mean the world to me, and I'll be able to come back and support in the future, regardless of what happens. And
maybe a future coach.
Maybe a future, maybe.
Good luck. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations on coming down on the AC medal. Just talk a little bit about it and what it means, especially in your senior year.
Yeah, it's a huge accomplishment, you know. Last year when I came to the tournament, I lost my first two, so coming back and taking eights, huge improvement, and I did alongside my friend Carter Fox. He's still wrestling for 34, so it was great. It was really, wish I got a little higher, but, you know, it's nice to be on the podium.
Talk about that with Fox. You guys seniors kind of being in Montville, and, you know, kind of getting down here. I know it's a huge thing for you guys and being friends. Just this is something you guys will be able to share going forward for life. Just what it means, and not, you know, not the finish, but just that whole journey again.
Yeah, it's been a long year, you know, doing really well. And we haven't had a placer since 2011, so we're going to make Montville history. Only three people in Montville have ever placed in the state, so it's really two in the same year. It's awesome. It's great to do alongside one of my good friends.
Now, is there anybody you could see in the young group you guys got coming in that you guys have been working with that you could take over, because you both being seniors can keep Montville going forward?
Yeah, Liridon Latka, you know, who's one away from placing. He had a tremendous tournament, and he's going to do great things next year, I think. Connor Matron had a great tournament, too. Went 2-2. Got to the round of 16 and did really well. I think he's going to do
He's great one of those up-and-comers you see. I mean, he's right there in the counties, and, you know, I mean, he's right there in the cusp.
Yeah, he's doing really well. I think got a great senior year, both of them.
His brother was the 2000 Parker.
Yeah,
Parker
was he was good, too.
Yeah, he was very good. And you could kind of see, you know, I remember seeing Connor at the matches, and you kind of saw him, and then you realize, oh, wait a minute, you know, they grow up, and you're like, oh, that's the brother.
Yeah.
It's funny seeing that when you see them come together. How does this, looking back on your career, being the last match of your high school career, looking back, I know it's tough, you finished 8th, you want to finish higher. How do you feel your career went at Montville, just as a whole, and just in general?
I was just going to go back and go to Mall my freshman year and wrestle 4 years again, but didn't work out that way, but, you know, I did what I could. Had a rough sophomore year because I only wrestled the second half of the season. But I did pretty well my junior and senior year. So overall career, pretty good. That was happy.
Congratulations. Good
Thank
luck,
you.
Kyle.
Appreciate it.
Congratulations. Just wanted to get your thoughts, not only on your season, but just your team as well. Just how it feels to be a medalist at stakes.
It's surreal. I mean, my goal from the beginning of the season was to get on the podium this year, and I came into practice every day working hard along with my other guys, and we had 7 guys come down here and 4 of them place, and it's an honor to be placing where I am and to see how my hard work pays off. So
now you guys, this is your goal. We've talked about it in the preview videos we do. Coach Stoll has a number on there saying this day is still many days till Atlantic City. that approach and coming down and you guys coming together, how fun is it just to be with these guys? Like LJ, I saw you guys after you both, after your matches, you hugged each other, and you know, the young team you got with Tavoso coming down and those guys, just what it means for this squad going forward.
I mean, I think our group of guys is it's a family. I mean, I play football and lacrosse, and I don't think there's any other sport like this one where the camaraderie of the team is as good as it is. And I call each and every one of my guys my brothers because we're so close, and I take a bullet for any one of my guys, so it's really a...
Hopefully you won't have to.
Yeah.
If they're shooting at the bar, we're going to have an issue about some security.
But, yeah, I mean, it's awesome. I love these guys till forever, so...
Talk a little bit about your coaches too, because I know Stoll seems like he's a very quiet, laid-back guy until you see him out Madside. Yeah. He's the loudmouth, and Russo in the room is the loud one, getting you guys fired up, and it's the reverse. How they, you know, bring it together and bring you guys together, because you're not all from this, you know, most teams can get camaraderie because they went together all through school. You guys don't have that luxury. Just how they bring you guys together and make you fit in.
Yeah, I mean, Coach Stoll and Coach Russo, they're total opposites, but I mean, they really... To have a balance of these two is just awesome. We have guys pushing us all the time, and they have a balance of pushing us and then having fun together. So I really think that you got to wrestle hard and have fun at the same time to be able to have success, and that's what we do in our room. So that's why we have success.
Now, looking back on this season, do you consider this a season of success with the podium? I know obviously you want to get a little higher. How do you feel this season?
I think it was a really big success. After losing in the county finals, I posted a picture on Instagram saying, last night I took a loss, but in March I'm going to bounce back, and that's what I did. I actually beat that kid for to go into the Consti semis today, and, you know, that was my goal to come in and place, and so I see it as a success, definitely, and I got the job done.
Is it a little bit of a extra on top that you beat him to get to where you were? Because it was so close in the counties that it was like right down to the end. Was it even an option?
I mean, I beat him in the last few seconds. So it was really, I didn't know I was going to wrestle. We were talking a little bit and talking about his friends and stuff. And then we ended up wrestling each other. So it was a good revenge match for me. And I got to a place even higher than I wanted to. I just got on the podium, and I mean, maybe I would have liked to win one of these matches this morning to get a little higher, but I'm happy where
it's
I am.
It's always tough. It's such a grind this weekend, but congratulations, good luck, and I'm sure we'll be seeing you again.
Thank you.
Have a great season coming down here, but I'll just talk a little bit about it and how it feels right now.
It feels awesome because, I mean, it's something I always wanted to come down here and wrestle, embrace that atmosphere and see how it was, but the medal made it a lot better.
So, you had a great season this year, too. Win the counties, come down here and medal. Your biggest fan, your dad, always watching. Talk a little bit about that. And, you know, just the last couple of years. I mean, you seem to almost hit a switch here in between your sophomore and junior year, and it's just been lights out.
Yeah, I mean, freshman year started off, I used to not like wrestling as much, but then, I don't know, I slowly, developed, liking it, so then,
But is that a byproduct of your dad being involved with it? You're kind of rebelling a little bit? Or was it just you didn't personally like it?
I just personally didn't like it. I mean, I was more football, and then eighth grade, I remember I started maybe a little more, and I remember going down to eighth grade states, getting beat up, and watching Kyle Dake win his fourth title, and I was wow, it's something I want to be, I want to do that. So that's when I started wanting to go to club and started getting better. It's kind of what I worked for then, to come down here.
Talk a little bit about your coaches too. I know Malek kind of been working with you. You've almost sort of been an own assistant coach, especially because you've had such a big room with kids. Just kind of what he's been passing on to you, he almost relies on you, just kind of what he's taught you in his 2 years of school.
Yeah, I mean, he's taught me a lot, not just on the mat, but off the mat, how to be a better person, and a lot of mentally things too, because, I mean, it's not just wrestling physical, mentally, it's a big game, so he taught me a lot about that, becoming stronger mentally, and pushing kids, and getting a lot better shape, so.
Now, your high school career is wrapped up. I know it's too soon, it's way too soon for reaction, but how do you feel your overall career was like? Are you satisfied with your career?
Honestly, yeah, I don't really have any regrets. I mean, I'm kind of happy how everything went. I mean, whatever losses happened, I'm almost happy they happened. Everything worked out how I wanted to at some point. So.
Congratulations.
Thank
good luck
you.
College. Thank you. Congratulations on a successful year. Just talk a little bit about it and how it feels to be a state medalist.
It feels good. I was expecting something a little bit better, but we're all chasing after the same goal. And it's always good, if you shoot high, you'll still land in the area. So I'm pretty happy with it.
talk a little bit about your teammate, Cole Madeline, right before you. You guys are the same way, room partners. How it feels, just the, you both can walk away from that.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I told him we were a duo, you know what I mean? Counties, districts, regions, everything together. He's a kid that I've known this a lot. You know, he made me better, I made him better. So it was really good to see him get on the court because I know he works real hard for it, and I think he deserved it.
He had mentioned, too, about the camaraderie, how he said he took a bullet friend, but I said, there's bullets at Del Barton, there's a whole other issue of security. But talk about how you guys, because you guys don't have that traditional way where you can come up through the feeder program and combine. But you guys, you know, with Stoll and Russo bringing you guys together, you guys are a unit. Just how that.
Yeah, I think it's actually better that we don't come up through the same like program because we all bring something different and we all accept what each other's bringing to the table. And it's all about just, you know, being as good as you possibly can be. And we're all chasing after that goal, getting to that goal with different methods. And I think it just helps out everybody equally.
Now, Sid, you didn't finish where you wanted to, but you know, your high school career is up. Talk how that feels. Like looking at it, are you satisfied? Can you 20 years from now be down here with your kids and be happy with how you
Yeah. Perform? I mean I didn't really start wrestling until like sixth grade, you know. It was something I kinda picked up on, I liked it, I fell in love with it. And you know, fast forward 6 years and 7 years and you know, I'm wrestling college next year, 2 times state placer, so I'm happy with it. You know what I mean? It was a good ride. I'm happy with the people I did it with and I wouldn't trade it for it.
Congratulations, boy. Congratulations on success for you. Just talk a little bit about it. I know we talked all year. Your goal was to get down here in place. Just how's it feeling now? I know it was a tough loss. Just kind of what your thoughts are right now.
Well, one of my goals was to get 100 wins. And I did that. And one of my goals was to place top five and place sixth. And, so I came close. Still stings a little bit because I beat the kid twice already and then lost to him, but he got the last laugh. But I'm just really hungry for him right now.
Is that the toughest? Like if it was somebody from like Collingswood or Timber Creek who you never saw, it's somebody you had wrestled before, and is that the toughest part of the loss?
Yeah, it's tough because it's almost unfair when you wrestle someone multiple times. Because the only place you can go is down from there. But, I mean, I won it the first time and the second time. He won it the third time, but he won it when it really mattered. So, yeah, it's just tough. It's just tough, but it probably means a lot more just because it wasn't someone random, someone that I've beaten before and know that I can beat.
Talk a little bit about your team. You guys are well represented down here. You have Victor going here in the next little bit. What does it mean for this program that you guys had such a great run into the group finals and this? How do you feel the program is going forward?
I know that Hunter and Kevin couldn't even make it down here, unfortunately. But those guys are state place winners. They are. I mean, even if they didn't do it, they're that of that caliber. And we got
very solid, very solid guys.
We got other guys like Jack Bauer and Grant Block and Anthony Romanello, Vincent Romanello. And some underclassmen like Luke Bakarian and the guys stepping into fill-in positions and make moves there. I mean, outlook for our team, I think we're going to be very, very good in the coming years. Maybe not as good as we were this year, because this year
you had a great group of guys. Yeah. I mean, I think if we were talking about in the beginning of the season, we maybe lost one senior from last year's squad going in, or maybe none. I mean, you had a really good group of juniors that stepped in and came in. I mean, you guys really didn't miss a beat. You know, with your group run.
We lost one district finalist, Connor Wheatley, great guy, great wrestler. But other than that, everyone that made it down to AC was an underclassman. So it was great to come out of AC looking at next year, saying, all right, we're gonna be contenders for a state title. Unfortunately, we couldn't get that done, but we came close. And we have a great group of guys. We have a great attitude. Great work ethic in the room, and I know that we're going to be right up there at the top next year.
And finally, I know it's, you know, right after, it's a little rough looking at it, you know, through clear glasses. How do you feel your career at Huntington Central was? I mean, looking back on it, you know, I know you wanted to be higher on the podium, but when you're sitting there in 20, 30, 40 years talking to your kids or coming down here watching them wrestle, how do you reflect on your career at Huntington Central?
Well, I have the best coaches and the best team. It's tough coming down here, vision even, but made a lot of memories.
No, congratulations. It's been a pleasure covering you, and you know, it's, you always want, you always root for the nice kids, and you know, I'm sorry you couldn't finish higher, but just so you know, myself and all the reporters, when we talk about you, you're one of the nice kids. We love getting the quotes from you, and you go out there and back it up. You're one of the best wrestlers we've seen. You don't throw it in people's faces. You're always helping out, and that's rare in this day. So congratulations. You want to just talk a little bit about it, and just how it feels. I know you were down here last year, kind of snuck up on some people. You didn't have that luxury this year. You talk about that, how it feels to be a medal winner.
Feels good. I just like feeling coming back down here. It shows that, like, I didn't like just knock on people last year.
You weren't a one-hit wonder. You were sustained.
Yeah.
That always seems to be the way it validates it. Mm-hmm. We know you got your start late in wrestling, and you kind of just picked it up. Talk about how you guys kind of caught up with that, because you had Ayatex out here, who one of the first ones to congratulate you, came over and hugged you because you guys were done. And, you know, talk about, you know, your coaches, just how they've helped you get here. Because I know it's a unit thing at Hunter and Central. They all come together.
So, like, how they helped
you? Yeah, how your coaches came together, just what they meant to you being where you're at right now.
The coaches always believed in me, knew that I was going to be good and great and, like, had potential, so they believed in me, pushed me. So, like, in practice, because this year I didn't really have any practice months, like, good practice months, they would, like, he would have his brother, he would, like, get him in the ring for, like, wrestle other, like, older guys, I guess I had an actual partner sometimes, because I could, like, go by that shit.
Is that tough when you, because, you know, a lot of these guys who are 145, 152, they can pair up. Is it tough when you're a bigger 220 and trying to get in there and everybody else is lower and you just kind of sit there?
We had big guys, just they were not
really, they couldn't keep up with what you were trying to do. Like, you were, I understand, it happens. It's just the way to different levels, and you got to keep your stuff fresh going forward and kind of keep yourself sharp so you're not hitting that low when you get into the district or region. How do you feel about this year? I mean, you know, you're higher up. I mean, you improved on last year's performance. How do you feel at the end of the day?
I feel great. I feel like accomplished. I know maybe like my semifinal match I could have landed. I know I didn't shoot or do a lot of that match. But I'm glad I am now.
Could you imagine this when you first started wrestling, that now, these last 2 years, you're a state medalist and you have 2 medals at home. Could you imagine that starting out when you first saw the sport of wrestling?
No. Like my mom told, like, says a lot, like, she wouldn't have imagined. Like, when the first time we were here and, like, we saw an actual wrestling match at the school, she was, like, really glad to see, like, my son's name up in, like, the names of, like, varsity. And she didn't, none of us thought I would have been here.
Well, now the good thing is your mom can go in and see you listed with the names who have won state medals for Hunter and Central. Congratulations. Talk a little bit about this coming down here and battling it as a heavyweight, just kind of what it means coming down here with a teammate.
It just means, like, I came in as a sophomore, and so the program, it really means that they can get someone from a first year to place in the state tournament in 3-4 years, and that's huge for me, for the coaches, for the team, and just for the whole program and the school.
Knowing that when you walk into that locker room 10, 20, 30 years from now, you look up at that board 2017, yep, your name's up there that you met.
I'm just going to look back and just think, this is the hardest thing I ever loved. It was great. I look back, so many good memories, friends, opponents.
Wrestling's like an abusive relationship. You love it, but then there's times when you're grinding and you're doing it and you're sweating and you're looking at your arm and you got different stuff on it and you're like, why am I doing this? And you realize. Yeah, obviously, you know, you want to finish higher, but your program's in a good position. Talk about your coach. You said you've got you ready for this in 3 years.
Yeah.
Talk about Crip, talk about those guys and what they do in the room, you know, to get you ready for this.
You know, Morris, he'll roll around with me sometimes. He'll give me some pointers. Templeton, he comes in now and then and, you know, beats up on me, shows me some new things. Crip will give me some little tips when I'm having trouble with something. He'll kind of correct it and help me through it. And Devon's there just to keep me pushing, you know. He'll just yell at me and give me a pat on the back, say, get up, keep going. And they all do their job for me and get me through it.
Finally, looking back on it, now, I know you just came off the mat, but looking back on your career, the 3 years you had, how do you feel you did? Like, how do you feel you did personally? Are you happy?
I'm so happy. I've won almost everything I could have. I'm so much more. I've placed Morris Knowles, Lenape, regions, districts, 100 wins.
You won at counties with your brother, and we have said that a couple times.
Twice at counties, and then twice at districts and regions. So, and then placing at states, that's like the cherry on top of the sundae. It really, it just rounds everything off nice.
Would you have been satisfied if you didn't play at state because you had won region to districts, or is this kind of like your end goal and you're just thrilled?
Yeah, I kind of think about it as everything I've done for the past 3-4 years kind of has been leading me to this moment. I was thinking that right before my match. It's huge, like I can do this, I'm prepared, I know what I'm doing. So it just helps round everything off, because coming here and not placing, that would kind of, it would take a lot away from me, because it's what I've been looking at.
The end goal.
Yeah, it's the finish line. I finally got it.
Perfect, congratulations.